everyone, it is Professor Olean, and today we're going to do something a little bit different. Before we get started, I do want to say, if you did contribute to the Hurricane Helene victims, thank you. I want to encourage everybody to please consider doing so if you have not already. I'll have some links in the description, the nc.gov/donate link that goes to the North Carolina Disaster Relief Fund, which is controlled by the United Way. That is the organization that I give to. I give through payroll deductions, have been for years. That money goes to the nonprofits that are involved in the disaster relief. And I'll have another one. It's a group that I think they're based out of Statesville that is airdropping supplies to the victims that are still cut off, and it's been hundreds of thousands of pounds worth of supplies that they've dropped. So I'll have those two links in there. One thing that I will say is, if you are considering going up there to volunteer or going up there in person, that you really need to coordinate through a nonprofit. Don't just show up there. There's a lot of information that's been coming out that's, I'm not gonna really comment too much on it. The information's not correct, and it really kind of makes me mad because that information is being politicized. These victims are being used. Leave it at that. So, with that being said, this game, I swear. So if you haven't guessed, I'm in Transim World. This is actually TSW 5. No, I did not buy it. You have until October 17th if you've bought previous versions of TSW. You can get it for free, and it's probably because Dovetail caught so much flack last year for this mic, so you might hear a little mess. They caught so much flack last year for re-releasing the same game over and over and over again. if you get it before October 17th, I believe that's the date, you get it for free, which just goes to show me that really it's not really a new game, which I think most of us knew. It's not a new game that you're getting every year. You're getting an update and a route, and maybe some trains. Who knows? But what I was going to do is, this is a comparison between Run 8 and TSW-5. Now, I can already tell you how this is going to go. I have not ran this yet. This is an older one. I don't think these have been updated yet. It's getting there in terms of handling. I did run a very brief bit in this game, but it's still missing something. The other thing is, I was actually going to take this consist, start them both at 6 o'clock in the morning, that way you can see the day to night or the night to day transition. And lo and behold, you can't do that in Transim World. It has a, what do they call it, formation something or other. It's like, okay. So I tried to build a train through that, and I was going to actually create this train, and you can create this train, but the thing is, you can't load it. I'm like, common functionality in most train games is the ability to load and unload cars, and you cannot load cars in their formation thing. And I'm just like, and then it's so difficult to do anything in this. No! Oh my god. You can see how this is going to go. I'm not gonna bash it. I'm actually, as soon as I get in this cab, I'm going to turn off my microphone, and you won't hear from me again. For the rest of this video, we're going to take this train. This is MUSDG, and we're going to take it from Barstow, which is where we are right now, if you haven't figured that out. We're going to take it from here. Yes, it is laggy because of the fog. We're going to take it from here to Summit. And I ran it earlier in Run 8, and there'll be a side-by-side of the two. It took an hour and a half in Run 8. This game says it's going to take an hour. Now, the telling factors is going to be there's a ruling grade between here and there. There's one that's 1.6 and one that's 1.5. And the HPT of this train, according to Run 8, I really haven't set down and figured it up. It's right at 6,000 tons. Is about 3.1. So if you stick to our formula of 1 HPT over 1% grade at 10 miles per hour, we should be going up that 1.1% grade at about 31 miles an hour. So between 30 and 33 in Notch 8. If this thing takes off like a rocket, which I don't think it will, but I'm curious to see how it does on grades, I'll be able to compare it. There is one thing that I will say. Somewhere before Oro Grande, I can't remember exactly where it is, in Run 8 I slowed down, and the reason why I slowed down was there was a Z train that was crossing over at Oro Grande, and so instead of deleting the train, I just went ahead and followed it. I was running in one of my busy saves, so there were a lot of trains. We passed a lot of stacked trains on that one. I don't know how many services are actually working in this one, and that's another thing. You can create timetables, but it's an absolute pain. So I'm going to stop talking about it. We'll do the side-by-side. It'll probably be some split screens and some cutting and some editing. But you can see how the two compare. And I'll go ahead and give you my final thoughts. I still prefer Run 8, just the little bit of time that I've played in this. Yeah, and that's all I want to say about that. So, with that being said, I'm going to hop in the cab. Actually, I'm going to mute my microphone. I'm going to hop in the cab, and then we're going to take off. So, enjoy the video.
Temperature 4.1 degrees. pressure, mile post 42.6, main 2, temperature 41 degrees. temperature 4 degrees.
I wasn't gonna say anything, but I don't know. This is a it's weird how they did this map. I was actually using my Run 8 maps, and the speed limits are really weird. They don't match what's trackside. So anyway, as you can see, and let's see, speed. Speed limit here, and then my speed. So we only busted it one time. But yeah, I mean, it's got these weird speed limit steps in it. Like right here, why did it go up to 65 for like a third of a mile or something like that? It just train simulators always had that problem. Anyway. Would I recommend Trains in World 5? No. I mean, if you had it before and you can get it for free, sure, go ahead. But I don't know if you saw it, but coming up that 1.6 and it's sitting there holding 40 mile an hour, and I'm like, is this an ACE? Is it an AC unit? And it's not. It's a DC. It's a 44. It's a 44 C4. So it's a. Well, let me just double check. I'm pretty sure a C4 is still a. I want to make sure. Oh, it is AC. Yep, C4s are AC. So that's not terribly. No, the C4 still has two traction motors per truck. Yeah, no C4 for a built with DC, so it's an AC. So 40 mile an hour is probably good, is probably about right then. So you would say, I don't know, a 1 HPT would go over 1% at roughly 12 or so, 12 to 15. So that's not the end of the world. But yeah, this train still feels really weird. The brakes feel funky. The right there at the end, when I put the thing into suppression, I was actually watching the equalizing reservoir. So I'm moving, trying to move the brake handle to Matt to watch the equalizer and reservoir read out. And then the next thing I know, it's like 60. And I'm like, holy God. Anyway, meh. I'm. The other thing that I don't like about this is if I were going to take this train on to San Bernardino, I can't do it. I have to exit out of this. I have to go back into the timetable, pick the next one, and then go on from there. I can't just take this train straight from Barstow to San Bernardino. So it's a bit annoying, but what are you going to do? Anyway, that is all I have to say about this. Like I said, if you have the previous versions, by all means. If you're planning on buying Trains in World, unless you really, really, really like the graphics, pass. It's not worth it in my opinion. None of the ones that they've put out have been worth it. The only reason I got Trains in World, I can't remember if it was three or four, was because I got it for like $5. So, anyway, hope you enjoyed. I'll see you next time.